In the Peruvian Andes, the ruins of Chavín de Huántar preserve remnants of the pre-Inca civilization that flourished here from 1300 to 500 BC. Stanford archaeologist John Rick has spent more than 25 years exploring its mysteries, and now robots are aiding the effort, going where humans can't go.
Chavín de Huántar is really mythical within Latin American archaeology and well known within worldwide archaeology.
Rick has helped reveal the religious significance of Chavín, where priests used rituals, architecture, and technology to simulate supernatural abilities.
We have underground spaces that are dark and mysterious. We have evidence of manipulation of sound and light. We have evidence of the use of psychoactive drugs. All these things which contribute to creating a credibility that the leadership of Chavín is not only in contact with greater power, but that they could also transfer aspects of this to the people who came into the cult of Chavín.
The site has hundreds of underground passageways and small ducts connecting them to each other and the outside world.
Robots were a natural in some sense. Many of these underground spaces are not easily entered. That's one aspect. But there are spaces that we don't have a lot of confidence in. The level of risk here is huge.
Stanford engineering student Margaret Coad is helping explore Chavín with the Vinebot, a remote-controlled snake powered by compressed air. And this Andean labyrinth is an ideal place to field-test the robot.
Let's hope it works.
Equipped with a camera, Vinebot was able to see things at Chavín that no human had seen for 3,000 years.
We think we can start to get into the mindset of Chavín, what they understood, what they were trying to do, what their architecture was up to. These underground spaces are key.
To help get into them, Stanford engineering student Jack Lane co-developed a wheeled rover to perform field archaeology. This year, it made a startling discovery, a 2,500-year-old vase in near original condition. The current rover can't retrieve artifacts, but it can locate them, determine whether they can be safely removed, and even record robot co-developer Daniel Chan recovering the find.
Wow!
We've been here for 25 years doing mapping, large-scale excavations, and now a lot of work in site conservation. Getting instruments in that can become our eyes and ears, this means that we can reduce the destruction of the archaeological record because we can get the answers without excavating. This has just immense potential. We're talking about whole new ways of looking at archaeology.